to think that they too are beloved children of God. How can God love them? How can we love them? One youth said, "That is really hard for me. I struggle to see people who have hurt others as children of God, and that I have something in common with them." But then another youth, who'd been made fun of in school, said this: "When someone bullies you, you can't be mean back to them. That never solves anything. You just have to be kind, and you have to stand with people who are being bullied so they know they aren't alone." When asked where they saw God's love in this past pandemic time, one youth commented how it was in the many people who stood up in support of Black Lives Matter and LGBTQ lives. He saw God at work in those people, in those actions. And his brother summed it up: "I know we're here to see God through each and every one of us. And the important thing to do with our lives is to love and help others." And this is where joining a church and baptizing Ellie into this household of God helps us all on this very human journey, full of uncertainty and fear, and frankly, people we don't agree with and people we don't like. This is like a second home, one youth said, a second home where I can be known, a place where there is care for me and others, and where I can go to learn about and develop my understanding about God and Jesus. I love coming to church because there's a community of people I've known my whole life, and it's a place devoted to learning about God and getting better at forgiveness and love. So here we all are, in our little boats, sailing calm seas, sailing stormy seas, with peace, with gratitude, with fear. And it's in the stormy, fearful times that's when we get to practice. We're nothing more and nothing less than God's beloved children. And so is everyone else. Confirmation youth, we give thanks to God for you. We are blessed and honored to have you as part of our community of faith, this family of God. You help us all live lives of faith, even when we're scared. Thanks be to God. So today we are celebrating, and as I call your name, if you and your mentor or your mentor stand in, you come forward. We are celebrating that Alex Papanicolaus, Caleb Papanicolaus, Jamie Albertine, Lizzie Albertine, Noah Eubanks, Noah Gregory, Noah Bolthouse, Sam Ferretti, and Zach Ferretti are confirming their desire to walk this path of faith, having studied and journaled and discussed and shared personal statements of faith. So have your mentor stand next to you.
Service. doing the benediction. You have to sit in the far back, right behind them to see this happen. But Abby has made sure that her boys understand Amy's benediction every week, and I think it shows in the faith that's coming out of them now. And so I'm very grateful that Zach is here.
This is Sam Freddy, Zach's older brother. I've had a chance to know Zach for a long time now, and I think one of the biggest things about Zach is how big his heart really is, and his concern for others. He really puts that forefront in his life, and he's always looking for ways to make the world better, whether it's the world as a whole, or whether it's just in his community where he lives. So I always look at that as a real big thing for us, and a good thing for this church, with having Sam here, as he's always looking how we can improve things to make people's lives better. So I really appreciate that in Sam. So I also want to introduce Alex Valdez today, because his mentor was Kevin Winter, but not Peter did. So Alex is going into his senior year of high school, so he's getting to that point where he's going to start thinking about what's next. He's also now a fully licensed driver, which you can do what you will with that information. But I know it's a little terrifying with a little road table over there, so. But the things, not being his mentor, but still knowing Alex for a long time as well, even though he doesn't always show it, he has a big heart, especially for his family. Even though Caleb may not always feel it, there's a big spot in his heart for Caleb, and he likes to look out for his little brother, for sure. And through this confirmation process, it was a real eye-opening experience, I think, for him to know that, you know, even during these trying times over the past year, having his family there is really important. And the other thing about Alex is, again, may not show it, but he's really passionate. And so far in his young life, his big passion is shown through his love of soccer. I'm always amazed at how he seems to always be playing on two or three teams at a time, and always trying to get back on the field even when he's injured. So, thank you, Alex.
I'm introducing Noah Eubanks on behalf of Val Brown, who can't be here today, and so Val emailed me something that she might be reading to you. She writes, Noah and I first met when he was sitting in church with his mom, Natalie. As I passed the piece to the row behind me, I was introduced to Noah. When I helped in Sunday school, I was able to get to know Noah too. Noah is very active in Boy Scouts and enjoys all of the activities, including camping and assisting with the Chili Summer fundraiser. He is headed to Goshen for camp this summer. Noah is very compassionate and reached out to others who are struggling. He feels closest to God when he is outdoors and especially hiking. Noah knows that he is a child of God. I am so glad that I've got to know Noah and proud that he's being confirmed.
This is Nola Volkeis. She has been a member here, or coming here since she was a year and a half years old. She's now going into eighth grade, and she's into the arts, which I especially love. She plays the violin, and she's been into drama. And she has a history book. I think she's an insightful, wonderful person. She's just so smart and creative, and we should be very proud to have her as a member here.
We might have to move towards the microphone.
This is Lizzie. This is Elizabeth Jane Alberti, also known as Lizzie. I've known her for 13 years now. She's been a member of LB. She's come to LBC her whole life. Her family as well, and her, I believe one of her grandmothers is giving her probably maybe 5 decades. She loves art. 3 years of Lizzie's 13 years were spent and she appreciates the diversity. This was reflected in our confirmation entry as she explored her beliefs and disbeliefs. And it's been a joy going through that process.
Can you all move down so that people can hear to the microphone? I'd like to introduce Jamie Albertine, my grandson. Jamie, as Gary said, grew up in this church. He's baptized here. He went to the nursery here. He went to Sunday school here. And then during his 5th, 6th, and 7th grade years, he was in England, Northern England, and as Gary said, he was in college all these years. So he got to go to British schools, which is another experience, and good move for him, I think, and widened his horizons also. They returned here about 2 years ago. The family was very relieved, except we did enjoy that traveling when you go to visit them. Jamie will be a sophomore in Sandy Spring Prince School this fall. He is an avid gamer. He likes to run. He likes to spend time with his friends, which of course is hard during the pandemic. But he managed through his online technology skills to keep in touch with both his friends in England and here. And also with the LPC youth through Zooming. And yes, he likes to remind me that he's a little bit taller than I am.
So, Alex,
were all physically separated during that time, yet still we were all part of the LPC family of faith. So once we could meet again in person, you've committed to exploring your faith together and with your mentors. You've been invited to reflect on what matters most to you, how these past months have affected how you see the world, how you understand your place in the world, and how God's love is always our guiding light.
Do you promise to do your best so there's nothing more and nothing less than God's beloved child? Do you promise to do your best to see in every part of God's creation, every person and every creature, the image of the Creator? Do you promise to do your best to follow Jesus' teachings and model, even as you know that sometimes you will fall short? And do you know that no matter what, nothing in life or in death can separate you from the love of God in Christ Jesus?
So if the confirmands, the youth can kneel in front of their mentors.
Mm-hmm.
pray together. Living gracious God, we give you thanks for these youth, for their journeys until now and in the future, and for this moment when we celebrate the gift they are to the world, for everything in them that is good and kind, faithful and funny, daring and doubtful. You've gathered these youth to you, and you share them with us. And together, you make us a more faithful household of Christ. Open our hearts to one another that they may strengthen us and we them as we discern the path of love and forgiveness you call us all to walk, individually and together, in Christ. Now you all know, right, you memorized, for nothing in life or in death can separate us from the love of Christ. And so, you don't have to have it memorized, but just in case, here it is with your name on it, so that you can know that nothing in life or in death can separate you to God. So thank you all, and thank you to the mentors.
To go into the e-news and the bulletin. If anybody has an iPad that they could do without for a while, I'm trying to get something in front of Betty Murphy so she can see the worship services, especially once we start streaming them live, that she'll have a means of being together with us and in historical mode, she can go back through all of the worship services that have been posted on YouTube. So if anybody has an iPad, they'd be willing to, if nothing else, just loan for a while. Betty would be eternally grateful. Also, I just completed my first week of training at Annapolis Subaru. I know that might be a shock to people that think Andy's selling cars, but this is a very unique dealership, and I'm extremely comfortable and happy and excited to be at this place.
Anyone else? Yes, Steve.
Friday, we're going to a test across Canada, so just driving
this coming week, we're celebrating and having a memorial service for my mom. Just prayers for everybody's safe journeys and discernment.
Let us open our hearts to God as we join in prayer. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks for this amazing day, for the joy of coming together, of hugs, of seeing each other, of making real eye contact. We give you thanks that we can gather to worship you, to welcome new people into our household. And this day, we especially give thanks that Jake is able to be here on leave with his girlfriend Olivia, be with them as they're about to journey to two separate Air Force bases, one in New Mexico, one in Hawaii. We know that you will carry them close. And we give you thanks that Patricia's neighbor Dennis, who graduated in 2019, was finally able to get a job. Be with all those who are searching. Be with all those places who are short-staffed. Be with us as we emerge from this time in this country. And help us to find ways to connect with those who can't join us here physically. We know that in you, there's no more for south, east, or west, but it's good to be able to have a way to be together. And be with Andy as he begins his new work with Annapolis Subaru. And be with Steve and Roseanne and Nola and Gabe as they cross the border into Canada, as they do all the testing and the quarantining they need to do for Gabe. And be with them as they reconnect with family after such a long time. And be with Cheryl in this coming week and her whole family as they gather for her mother's memorial service. We ask safe journeys, and we give you thanks that they too are able to gather in your name in person. And this morning we lift up to you Jean and Everett. We know you are holding Everett close, and we know that Jean is surrounded by family and friends. And yet this time of transition as they wait for you to take Everett home is such a hard time. Be with them and give them strength. And be with each of us and hear us as we pray as Christ taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now let us offer back to God what has been entrusted to us.
Thank you.
And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and God be gracious unto you. May God give you grace to never sell yourself short, grace to risk something big for something good, and grace to know that the world is too dangerous for anything but truth, and too small for anything but love. And now